innovative community-based models for early childhood development in Pakistan being implemented for the last more than one decade. So I'm going to share one of the models with you today. This model is called Agah Walidain, Informed Parents, developed by Rupani Foundation in 2006. It's an approach which basically tries to promote holistic development of children, focusing on cognitive, physical, emotional, language, social, and ethical development of children from preconception to age 8. The key point here, which really distinguishes this model from the other models which are being implemented in Pakistan, is the age group of children. Because in Pakistan, usually the models or the approaches are mainly from age 3 onwards children. I think this is one of the unique models, and this is one of the key models, I would say, which works very closely with parents and communities and focuses on children even before they are conceived. So I will talk about the details later on in my presentation, but I would like to just highlight here that this age group, which we know is very critical for the overall development of the children, has been taken care of in Pakistan. So the model is based on the science of ECD, as we all know that the latest research about brain development tells us that it's very critical to invest in the early ages of children, and we have to really take care of the mother's health even before she conceives the child. So this model is basically trying to link the research with practice, and it is doing it very successfully. Another theory which the model is based upon is the attachment theory. As we all know that bonding of children with their parents and bonding of children with their siblings and other extended family members really play a great role in the overall development of the children. So the model focuses on mother and child health, nutrition, child protection, early learning and stimulation, and responsive caregiving. This was first developed in collaboration with the Ahan Foundation in 2006, and it was pioneered and piloted in Gilgit-Baltistan. And now I'm very honored and very pleased to say that this model and this center in Gilgit is really working like a hub for the rest of the centers which have been established in other parts of Pakistan. So this is really working like a laboratory, training caregivers, training the family support motivators, and also sharing the latest research with parents and with community and community leaders. As you can see that this approach heavily depends on the involvement and engagement of parents and community. So the objective of the model is to educate and empower parents about their role in the child's holistic development, to enable them as lifelong learners through timely rendering of information, care, and stimulation during the early years of their life. It's very important that we give the due care, the required care, support, and early stimulation right at the beginning of the children to make them successful citizens, productive citizens, and lifelong learners. And this approach is really working towards achieving this objective. As I mentioned, that it focuses on the children even they are conceived. So this is targeted dating women, families which includes children, their parents, their grandparents, and their siblings, community leaders, civil society organizations, government, academia, and donors. These are all the key stakeholders and key beneficiaries, rather key decision makers in this approach. So far, Rupani Foundation has established 138 centers across Pakistan. Most of the centers are in Gilgit-Baltistan, in Sindh, and some parts of Punjab. But the aim is to reach to every single child of Pakistan through providing these services and through with the in partnership with the government and communities. I will not go into the numbers because I think can you see them? Can you see the figures? Okay, so right now, currently the children which are enrolled in the 138 centers are around 9,000, and many children and their parents and grandparents have already graduated, and we have some amazing success stories of the children who have graduated and have gone into different schools, and we have some amazing stories to share with you about how grandparents and how other extended family members take part in the activities with the children, and they help the mother and the parents in upbringing of the children. The model is basically, it's a center-based plus home visitation and engaging overall society in the activities which are being carried out for the children. So the center-based program offers sessions for parents, both mother and father, their children, and family members for 5 days, 5 days a week for 2 to 3 hours. And the age group of children has been divided into the following categories. Infant includes 0 to 12 months, younger children from 12 to 18 months, older children 18 to 24 months, preschoolers 24 to 36 months, and then children from age 3 onwards, which go to other, which go to mainstream schools, both public and private schools. So the center-based activities include free play, learning, calendar time, the usual daily routine which is being followed in the ECD centers. The same routine is followed here, but the activities are carefully designed based on the latest research and based on the brain development and also the overall focusing on all domains of the learning domains. And the key people who play an important role in this model are the family support and motivators. These are the professionals who are being trained by Rupani Foundation's technical team, and Rupani Foundation also takes support from external resource persons from other than Pakistan, and they really spend time on developing their materials, their training modules, and training the family support and motivators. And these family support motivators conduct the sessions at the center, as well as they visit the homes of the families who are registered with the ECD center. And they, during the home visits, they talk to the parents about the milestone, age, developmental milestones, and age-appropriate activities, how parents and families can turn the house into child-friendly home, and how they can take part in the activities with their children, how they can help their children develop through play, through spending time talking to them, reading to them. So So all sorts of activities are being created at homes of the children. So they do not just get the exposure at the center. When they go back home, they really get a similar environment at home as well. So realizing their, you know, nature of work and other engagements, Rupani Foundation has designed a program which is called Me and My Dad. So in these sessions, fathers come with their children twice a month to center, and they are being oriented about the daily routines and what kind of activities the children are doing with their mothers when they come to the center. So the fathers also have an orientation of the activities, and they are encouraged to take part in the activities as well. And we have again very you know, success stories of fathers being actively engaged in the upbringing of their children. As I had mentioned earlier, that the model also has opportunities for pregnant women newlywed couples. It's, I think, responsibility of all the stakeholders, especially sitting here, to educate our future generation and our future parents that their marital life and harmony in their marital life has a very, you know, direct impact on their future generation. So newlywed couples also come to the center once a month, and experts arrange sessions for them on marital harmony, healthy relationship, planning for the baby, and how it's like to be a parent, etc. So these sessions are really exciting. Initially, these were not taken very seriously, but after becoming parents, some of the newlywed couples have become role models for others, and they come and share their story and how they have benefited from these sessions and how they are taking care of their child after attending these sessions. So it's again very encouraging for us to involve these newlywed couples. Sessions for pregnant mothers on monthly basis by health professionals. Pregnant mothers in the vicinity of these ECD centers are registered with the center, and they are invited to the center once a month. Professionals from Alhan health centers and government health centers and other community-based health centers, lady health visitors, and sometimes doctors also arrange sessions on these important topics for the pregnant mothers. The topics include dietary and care requirements, pre and post pregnancy, common discomforts, routine checkups, hygiene, use of supplements, healthy exercises such as listening to music, reading, and doing mathematical games for optimum brain development of the child, pre and post natal yoga, and importance of breastfeeding and disadvantages of toe feeding, bottle feeding. All these topics are covered in these sessions. Other activities include yoga exercises for children and mothers, growth monitoring. Parents are educated on how they can monitor the growth of their children following the WHO standards. And music classes, as music has a very key role in the development of child's brain and physical development. So music classes for mothers and children are arranged. Chinese language has been introduced in one of the centers in Gilgit, and basic Chinese language like greetings, counting, names of fruits, animals, birds, vegetables, and days are arranged by trained teachers. events and celebrations, national and international days, Islamic and cultural events with the involvement of parents are being arranged. Mass awareness sessions, which play a very key role, and in those mass session awareness, community representatives, government officials, and other opinion makers take part, and they, especially in Gilgit-Baltistan, they have really played a key role in mobilizing communities and parents in to achieve the holistic agenda of early childhood development. Child protection and safety, as I mentioned earlier, that the approach focuses on child protection and safety. Sessions again are being arranged by experts on child safety and rights, survival, developmental protection and participation rights, creating nurturing environment, awareness about child abuse and its different forms, emotional health of children, awareness about substance abuse. So these are all the key topics which are being covered in the session by experts on child protection and safety. The program has an inbuilt monitoring and evaluation system, as well as it encourages external evaluations. So the external evaluation, which was being carried out in 2015, has identified that 85% children improved healthy food habits after ECD intervention, which was 15% prior to the program. One important thing which I would like to mention here is wherever this ECD center is being established, the Rupani Foundation monitoring and evaluation team makes sure that there is a baseline to compare the impact of the intervention. So they before establishing the center, they make sure they have a baseline. So the external evaluations have also taken into consideration of these internal baseline, this internal baseline data. 89% parents follow an explanatory parenting approach, which was 14% before the ECD program. 70% mothers increased their time spent with children after participating in Agah Walidain, informed parents, while it increased 24% in fathers. 93% households reported an increase in children's learning activities at home after ECD intervention, while only 15.5% homes encouraged any learning activities prior to this intervention. 100% transition to formal schools, 53% ECD graduates enrolled in formal schools were among the top three high achievers in the class, while 33% were placed among the fourth and tenth positions. 95% parents interviewed reported that ECD program helped their children build confidence. 77% said that ECD developed social skills in their children, and 74% ECD contributed to improve health and hygiene habits of the children. Arnick documented this model as one of the noteworthy documents and presented it in its conference, I think, in Nepal or Cambodia, I don't exactly remember, but this model has been presented as China, yeah, as one of the noteworthy, you know, practices. Other program impact includes awareness amongst the communities, increased on importance of early childhood development, improvement in health and nutritional status of children and mothers in the target communities, 100% transition, I already covered that, empowerment of women, including, because women have in the rural areas of Sindh, the mobile ECD service has two trained ECD teachers with other facilities, which are you know, which a model or prototype ECD center can offer to children. So this this mobile ECD goes to three locations per day, and It targets 15 children and 15 parents in one visit. So daily it goes to three locations, and so far it has covered 22 locations, and the plan is to add a couple of more mobile vans, especially to work in the areas where it's not really possible to open or establish any CD center. So we have again very encouraging feedback from the participants of from the beneficiaries of this mobile ECD service.
The Rupani Foundation as family support motivators.
The foundation has recently signed an MOU with Karakoram International University at the University of Haripur to offer certificate and diploma courses in ECD. These courses have included the content of Agah Walidain and the training details of Agah Walidain, so that these can be offered from the universities. Another very exciting news I would like to share with you is in September this year, during the international conference, Rupani Foundation signed an MOU with Allama Iqbal Open University to establish a center of excellence in Islamabad. So we all are really looking forward to establishing this center, and this center will inshallah offer research opportunities and training opportunities and loads of other, you know, capacity building programs to our ECD workforce. Other than these important partnerships, the foundation is also developing manuals for community health workers and offering capacity building sessions to them, and also translating the ECD literature, which is mainly in English, into since the literature is in English and the key messages are in English, we are trying to translate them into Urdu, and we have translated some of them in Sindhi, because in Sindh, you know, I didn't know that people mujhe nahi kehna chahiye itni Urdu shayad nahi bolte hain. When I went there, I was surprised to see that most of the mothers were speaking in Sindhi, so we had to translate the material for them in Sindhi. So this is it. Thank you very much.